We know that cauliflower has some benefits, and we know that turmeric has some benefits, but what about buffalo cauliflower? I'm not talking about some cauliflower that a buffalo harvested. I'm talking about using some good old-fashioned wing sauce and some spicy sauce on some cauliflower to make a delicious recipe that's not only tasty, but has some serious scientific backing behind you when it comes down to hormone modulation and helping you feel better. So I'm gonna break down this recipe for you, but I'm also gonna give you the science as I do it. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with the head of one cauliflower broken down into chunks like this. I've gone ahead and I've just purchased a bag to make it easy. Just use good old-fashioned organic cauliflower. Now, why am I using cauliflower? Cauliflower is what's known as a cruciferous vegetable. Now, it's a particular strain of cruciferous vegetable in this case. It's one that's known as a brassica. Okay, brassica is a very unique kind, and it's usually cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, it's gonna be things like kale, some broccolis, some baby broccolis. And basically what it does is it does some heavy hormone modulation, and it does this through something known as diindole methane, more commonly known as DIM or DIM, and also something known as IC3, indole 3 carbonyl. You see, what diindole methane does is it actually modulates estrogen levels within the body. And when we're talking about men, it really modulates estrogen because it prevents the aromatase enzyme from acting upon testosterone. You see, what happens is you have testosterone in the body, and as it's flowing through the bloodstream, it gets acted upon by something called the aromatase enzyme. The aromatase enzyme converts excess testosterone into estrogen, which can make us puffy, can make us hold water, and quite honestly, it can make us moody. So the diindole methane actually stops an aromatase from doing its job. So cauliflower is a lot more potent than you may have believed. Okay, the other thing is that IC3, that indole 3 carbonyl. Now basically what indole 3 carbonyl does is it modifies the biotransformation of certain enzymes in the actual body. So basically what it's doing is it's taking a lot more potent estrogens and it can help make them a little bit less potent. So you have bad estrogens and you have good estrogens in the body. And if we have too many of the bad estrogens floating around, then the good estrogens can't do their job. So this biotransformation that takes place from the indole 3 carbonyl ends up causing the body to really have a lot more of the good estrogen. Okay, that's enough fancy talk. So all we're gonna do here is we've taken this head of cauliflower and I'm going to add just about a half a cup of buffalo sauce to this. Okay, nothing fancy, just gonna totally make it so it's coated. Okay, that stuff tastes pretty good. The reason that we're using this buffalo sauce is simply because it's super high in cayenne. You can get a hot sauce, you can get all kinds of things, but buffalo sauce is exceptionally high in cayenne, which is high in something known as capsaicin. This capsaicin is high in something known as substance P. And I know I'm rattling off all kinds of scientific jargon here, but that substance P can really do a lot of things when it comes down to inflammation. It's been shown to modulate inflammation within the body. It's also been shown to reduce pain associated with inflammation. But it doesn't stop there. Capsaicin also has a huge effect on mitigating hunger responses in the body. It can actually affect your hormone levels like ghrelin and leptin to make it so that you don't crave as much. So there's a big reason that we put that in there. Okay, now I've got two good old-fashioned tablespoons of coconut oil. Now a lot of people wanna use olive oil and they wanna use avocado oil, and that's okay, but the thing is we're gonna be cooking this at high heat and we need an oil that's gonna be stable and that's not gonna turn into a highly oxidized poor fat source. So I've got two solid tablespoons of melted down coconut oil, which contains medium chain triglycerides, which is gonna allow the fats to actually be utilized for fuel. Now we get fun. This is where I throw a wrench in the recipe. I actually add some turmeric, and I add a lot of it. 1 to 2 full tablespoons of turmeric in there. And what that's gonna do is now we're gonna actually get the anti-inflammatory effects of the turmeric as well. So we've got the oils in here that are gonna allow the turmeric to be absorbed a little bit better. But just so that you know, when it comes down to absorbing turmeric, most of the time you're not absorbing it. You usually have to end up finding some kind of liposomal product or micellar delivery turmeric product to actually be able to absorb it. So you may not be absorbing a lot of the turmeric, but you're at least getting the flavor. Now I'm just kind of mixing this up until it's thoroughly coated. I really want this cauliflower to be completely coated, more so in oil than I care about the buffalo sauce. The reason I want it to be coated in the oil is because when I actually put it in the oven, that's what's gonna really make it actually cook all the way through and get that taste that I want. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit more turmeric in there because personally, I like the taste of turmeric. And if you combine the spice along with that turmeric taste, you actually get kind of a spicy Indian taste. So nothing fancy to it, just gonna go ahead and mix it up. But the trick now is to be patient. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set it aside, I'm gonna let it sit for about 20 minutes, and I'm gonna come back and talk to you for just a minute, not a full 20 minutes, about some of the science behind some of the other stuff we're doing here. So while that's marinating, you might be wondering why I have some celery on here. Now I'm gonna use celery as a garnish because it always goes good with what? Buffalo wings, right? Whenever you go to Buffalo Wild Wings or anything like that, they always have some garnish of celery. But I've got it here for another reason. You see, it contains something known as apigenin. Apigenin is a very specific kind of anti-inflammatory. You see, it actually reduces the expression of pro-inflammatory proteins in the body. And when I say reduces the expression of them, what that means is it stops the actual mutation. It stops these pro-inflammatory proteins from growing, from actually multiplying, from the cells from multiplying. So it's making it so you're stopping inflammation in its tracks. Now, you'd have to eat a lot of celery to really get that effect. But since we're combining it with turmeric and we're combining it with the anti-estrogenic components from diindolyl methane from the cauliflower, we're really in a good situation. But there's another thing that happens with the celery. The other thing that celery does is it contains a lot of prebiotic fibers to it. Now, prebiotics are actually the fertilizer for the gut bacteria. So when we're talking about a fertilizer for the gut bacteria, let's grab a knife here, we're talking about something that can actually help nourish the existing bacteria in your gut. What that's going to do is it's going to make it so that the bacteria in your gut that is already there can flourish. That way you're not having to add probiotics in. You're not having to always eat sauerkraut or take probiotic pills. You're just in a situation where your body is nourished and the bacteria that's already in your gut is working. So while that's marinating for about 15 minutes, I'm gonna cut to some lifestyle clips just to keep you entertained. All right, so it's been about 20 minutes. This has been marinating. See, it doesn't look a whole lot different. But what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get this oven up to 450 degrees. And then if you want, you can put a little bit of coconut oil down on this. This is a nonstick pan, so I'm not too worried about it. But all you're gonna wanna do is spread your cauliflower out. Now I will tell you, you wanna make sure that you don't let them clump together. So you wanna kinda spread them apart. Give them as much space as you possibly can. And I tell you right now, these little morsels right there end up being the ones that taste absolutely amazing. So you're gonna wanna eat those first before everyone else in your family goes to get them. Okay, so we lock that away for 20 to 30 minutes. You can check on it, see how it's doing. You can pop it on broil. If you wanna put a little bit of almond cheese or something like that on it, that works perfect too, but you wanna do that at the end so it doesn't burn. So let's come back in about 20, 25 minutes and see how that stuff's looking.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, that's good stuff. Cool.
All right. So it looks like this stuff's probably about good to go. It's been just about 20, 25 minutes. Perfect. A little bit of burnt oil on the bottom is not a big deal. Don't worry about that. Garnish up a little bit, just like its wings. And the whole idea here is you just want to treat it like they're hot wings. You're basically having buffalo wings without the meat, without the extra calories, but you're getting all the benefits of the diindolyl methane, you're getting all the benefits of the indole 3 carbinol, and you're getting the nuclear factor kappa B mitigation, so you're reducing inflammation all along the way. Now, like I told you from the get-go, it's these little teeny pieces that are the money. And that is so dang good. So you can make this at home. It's a perfect side. It's also perfect if you're just chilling out and watching some football on Sunday, because it's going to feel just like you're eating buffalo wings, except you're getting all the health effects without the calories. So as always, keep it locked in here on my channel. And if you have any ideas for future recipe videos, put them in the comment section below, and I'll check them out. I'll see you in the next video.